guys, I'm Caitlin.
I'm Joanne.
And today I'm going to be doing a drawing tutorial / drawing haul, would you call it?
Yeah, this is going to be pretty much Caitlin's video today. She's amazing at drawing. I know I'm a mum and I'm bound to say that she's really good, but she is really, really good at drawing. So today's video is a bit of her best work collection. And then after she's shown you like her favourite pictures that she's drawn recently, she's going to go to the table and do like a drawing tutorial for her. I could not have drawn any of these. I'll pass you over to Caitlin and she'll show you her sketchbooks and some of her sketches.
When I thought of was one of my favourites that I think is also mum's favourite.
You might have to go a little bit closer just so they see the central perk at the front.
Oh yeah.
We went to Friends Fest back in June, I think it was. We're very, very big Friends fans. And Caitlin picked up this notebook while she was there.
Yep.
I love this picture.
So, there's the picture. This probably took me about an hour. Okay, I kind of spaced it out a little bit.
Just try and hold it a bit stiller so they can see. I love the two, like, almost Princess Leia ones on the side. Yeah, that's definitely one of my favourites. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do like the hair. The hair's my favourite part of this one. And I like this detail on the shoulder.
I'm going to carry on with the jumper as well. I wanted it to be, like, a fluffy one that I used to have. So there's that. It took me probably an hour because I did it spaced out. Like, I might have done half an hour doing the overall base of it, and then maybe 15 minutes spaced out in the evening, kind of making it perfect.
I like this notebook.
Yeah, so I got three notebooks for my birthday.
These are all from The Works, by the way, and I think they still sell these. They do a really, really good range at a fantastic price of like lined notebooks and plain notebooks. So if you're into stationery like we are, then check out The Works.
So it says the best way to create your future, the best way to predict your future is to create it.
Show the back as well, because the back's really pretty, and the side, the spine.
And then the spine just says notebook. Like that. This is probably one that I have a lot of drawings in. So the first ones that I did were more like, I'm going to start off with the very first one in this one.
That's just like your cover page though, isn't it? It's not like sketched.
I got this on my 11th birthday, which is why I still love them on it. So it's not like my best drawing, but it was kind of just like, I got a lot of pens for my birthday. So I was kind of like testing out the pens. My friend got me like a big paper mate thing full of Sharpies and felt tips and highlighters. So that was kind of like this design. I kind of had like loads of different pens in it. And then my next one was just a Caitlin one that I just did as a front cover. I'm not sure how well you can see it. So it's kind of limited on how it can bend back.
But I see the sketches now.
Oh yeah, the sketches. So I'm going to start off with this one that I actually did on a drawing.
You might have to get that quite close up because it's quite a faint sketch, isn't it?
Yes.
I love this one. It reminds me of like something from Downton Abbey or something.
Yeah.
But I also think it looks a bit like eerie because it's just like the back of someone. It almost looks like a ghost.
But like,
love the hair.
Yeah. Oh, that's not great thing on it. Okay, this next one, I've been working so hard on how to get a nose.
She has. She's been working really hard on like facial features, and she's been watching loads of like YouTube how-tos on how to draw mouths, how to draw eyes, how to draw noses.
So this is just like a mouth and a nose, but I did the nose with the mouth, otherwise it would have looked a bit weird. Ooh. So there's my nose. I took me quite a while to get it perfect.
There's my sketches that are just so not good.
Oh, I want to show this one.
That one?
Yeah.
I like the hair. You're really good at hair. I love the hair on that one.
Right now, I am addicted to messy buns in my drawings. I'm always doing neat buns, messy buns, face buns. They're just really easy and simple to do. And I've got a bun maker. It's like, I think you call it a donut. And I kind of based it on that. And then I also have like a, this is just another doodle. Just a little doodle of a robin on a post box. And that's not my best work, but it was just when I was bored and I wanted.
I think your best work is actually up in your bedroom. You might have to like pull them down and then maybe at the end of this video show the ones that are in your room. In this notebook, I think my favourite I do like the cover of the flamingo. It's just like a little cartoony flamingo. We do like flamingos, but I think my favourite in this notebook is you're very good at doing the backs of people. I've just seen one where it's like a girl and a teddy.
Well, what I did, I got a load of cards for my birthday and I wanted to draw one. So Mum got me a flamingo one, which is what she just showed you. This one you got another one was. I can't remember who got me this.
It's a really good style though, to do like the backs of people.
Mm. But what I really liked about the actual card was the fact that it was like a pink shadow. It wasn't like a full on shadow, it was more like a sheer pink. That's what I liked about it.
Let's talk about this notebook. This is my favourite notebook.
It was our first day in Magic Kingdom and everyone was like allowed to treat. And I decided to get a sketchbook, and I really like this one. It's quite smart as well. It's like
gorgeous. Black,
and I like how it's got like sketches of Mickey's in it.
So it's like double layered as well.
Yeah.
I do love this.
The first one does have a meaning to it.
Don't disturb me. Oh, did you do this while we were in Florida?
Yeah.
The dates are while we were in Florida.
Yeah. So this took me quite a few days to get it perfect. Like, we would come out of the parks at about 3:00. To go back and like have a shower and maybe get a drink at the
Mara. We stayed at Animal Kingdom Lodge, didn't we?
Oh, I like this my favourite Disney princess is Tiana, and it's also Mum's favourite dress. So I did a design of her dress, and this might have been one of the first days, and we met Tiana on the first day. So there's Tiana.
Well, yeah, I definitely think at the end of the video we should do some shots of the pictures that are in your room, because you've saved the best ones to put up on your walls, haven't you?
Yeah.
Have you still got Dumbo?
Yes.
Definitely still Dumbo.
So I had. Ah!
Is that what's she called? Is it that Disney character? No, the one that with the glasses?
No.
Looks like her.
If you guys are into like. If you guys are just starting to begin art, you need to check out, he's called Christopher Hart on YouTube. He is an author who does his own drawings. So if you guys are into like more cartoon, it's like a cartoon series. I really like him. I think that for kids he is really cool.
They're very your style, aren't they?
Yeah. Comment down below which is your favourite. Is it the dog, the little girl who reminds me of Lilo, or the like Brainiac? Oh, I want to show this one.
I like the glasses with like the city behind.
My favourite thing to draw if I am bored are these glasses.
This fell out.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to show this one first. This is a Pikachu. Michael can just love Pokemon. Feels just kind of resemble to them. So it's going to be like a Christmas present. Quick doodles. So I went on YouTube and Google, and I have like a separate Google app, and you can click on images and you can type up anything and you will get a specific image or images of that. So I think I must have looked up quick doodles and I got some of these. So they're not.
Just a minute, I think the page is gone.
They're not the best thing I've ever drawn.
Yeah, but these were just like quick doodles while you were like in the queue for a ride or something, so they're very good.
Oh. Ooh, the next one.
And this is probably the last one, and then Caitlin will go on to her tutorial.
Yeah.
So. You are into music.
Yeah. I'm a big music fan. So I just drew like a girl with headphones because I was bored. When I'm bored, I either watch YouTube or do drawing or do both. So that's what I do when I'm bored. Like, I'll get a YouTube video up and I'll just sketch along. So yeah, and also I love this sketchbook. It's like proper. I save most of my good drawings to go in this.
So do you want to go to the table now, and then the next time everyone will see you, you'll be at the table doing your tutorial?
Yes. It's raining, but there ain't a cloud in the sky. since it's Christmas time, I drew a girl with a Santa hat on, and I really liked the design of it. So I decided that I wanted to do the same, but maybe add some different features, maybe the hair different colour and stuff. So I'm going to show you how to draw this in the simplest way possible, and comment down below if you do drawings like this at home. I do mine semi-realistic, so maybe the eyes have highlights from them, meaning that they're not as realistic as some. But without any further ado, let's start on with the tutorial. So I always start my face off with a circle. I find that it's the best way to get the best shape. So I just start by drawing a rough circle. It does not have to be the best circle ever. It can just be a faint circle. If you can't see this, that is just what it looks like. And it's just a nice faint circle as a base. So from the circle, I go down to the chin. I like my faces to be not really long, but not really short. And it sometimes takes me a while to get maybe the chin pointier or a bit flat. Or sometimes I'm just happy with it and don't want to go too far. So I'm quite happy with that. So what I do before I erase the circle, I'm going to get a bit closer up on this. I always draw the ears where the circle meets the face. So the circle is quite low. I'm going to do them a little bit higher up like that. And at first it doesn't look like too much and doesn't look the best, but as you add like the eyes and the nose and stuff, it can get quite good. So I'm just using this Papermate mechanical pencil that came in a Papermate set. So then I always move on to the hair or the neck, so I can get quite a nice, I don't know, I'm using base a lot, but it's probably the most artsy word to describe it. So sometimes it can take me a while. So I'm going to put this on fast play until I can get it right, and then show you the finished look of the actual base of the face. That rhymes. And then I can move on to the eyes and the nose. So if you guys aren't as good as very good at drawing eyes, then stay tuned. Okay, so now I have the neck right. I'm gonna start with the Santa hat because then I can start doing the hair. So I'm just gonna draw a normal Santa hat and color it in at the end, because this, when it's Christmas, I prefer to do colorful drawings, but maybe if I'm just doing a normal person, like a normal girl, I might prefer to just shade it. So again, sometimes it's gonna take me a while to get the perfect shape. Like for instance, that's more of a bonnet shape than a Santa hat. So I'm gonna start off by erasing the front bit of the very top bit, and that's going to just turn into a normal line, and I'm gonna start from that. So at first it won't look like much, it looks a bit like a sailor's hat, but once you draw the actual hat, it's gonna look quite good. So I'm going to move the camera a little bit so you can see. And then I add a little bit of detail when I do the cotton, like I kind of go in and out a bit like that. I'll try and show you with my other hand. I kind of go in and out to get more of an uneven, messy look, but that's kind of where I'm going. Okay. So then I draw lines down the face to show where the nose needs to be and where the eyes need to be. Before you guys continue watching, if you guys are not the best at eyes, the chances are they don't look good because you are doing them too far up. If you look at a person's face or a photo that you're trying to copy, you will find that the eyes are actually in the middle of the face, just below the forehead. The chances are that you're doing your eyes in the forehead. So that's probably where you're going wrong. I know this isn't a person, but if you have a look at this, the eyes are in the middle. So if you're trying to draw something cute or something face related, you're gonna need something that you can copy off where the eyes are in the middle of the face, and that's where you can begin. The eyes take me a while, so I'm gonna draw one eye shape, which is kind of like a lemon shape, and then I'm going to go on fast mode so you can see how long it takes me to get the eyes perfect. So I start off by making a point, or 2 points. And since I have lines, I know that my eyes are going to be rather symmetrical. So I go from 1 point to the other, and 1 point to the other. And when I'm happy with it, I just leave it, because when it's pretty much what I want, it's better than having nothing. So what I usually do is I always erase it when it's not perfect, and then I kick myself because actually it might have been the best that I was going to get. So then I kind of edit it and make it the best that it can possibly be. And then, this is weird, but I always add makeup to my people, like maybe eyeliner or mascara. So there is one eye, and it looks quite good right now because I'm using a mechanical pencil and they are darker, but as you can see, they still erase pretty well. So I definitely recommend these to sell these at Smiggle. But this is a paper mate one. But I'm gonna put this on to time lapse and you can see the finish of the two eyes, and then I'll go on to highlights and onto the pupils and the iris, and you can see how to really make your eyes look real. So yeah. So I'm gonna get a bit of a close up on the eye so you can see exactly what I'm doing. It didn't take me that long, as I think this eye I did smaller. What always happens is I do my eyes big and the other one is small, and it bugs me, and I'm there for like 10 minutes getting the perfect eye. But the reason I do this is because I am a bit of a perfectionist when it comes to drawing. But you're gonna start off, my hand is kind of in the middle. I'm gonna change positions and you can see how to do your eyes perfectly. I think eyes are my speciality when it comes to drawing, and to be quite honest, it takes a lot of practice. It's taken me a few years to get to where I am right now, and it probably will take you quite a while, because it did for me. So first of all, I do the pupil and the highlights. This is overall my favourite part of the entire drawing, but it's also what I tend to avoid. I don't know why I avoid this. I usually get quite nervous when I'm drawing eyes, and then it turns out really well, and yeah. So I'm going to shade in the pupil, because this is the perfect eye, and if I'm going to edit one, I'm going to edit this one. It looks a bit creepy, but when you add the eyebrows and you shade in the iris and you do the eyelashes and the mouth, it doesn't look that bad. So now I'm going to teach you how to do the iris. So since if you only paint the shade in, do a darker outline around the pupil. Then protect the highlight by doing another faint line around it. Then you want to roughly shade in the iris nice and faintly. For this you might want to change into a normal blunt pencil. A sharp ones do tend to be a lot darker and rougher. If you change to a blunt pencil, it's fine, but if you just roughly shade in like that, it can look quite nice. Then add a few lines around the iris to make it look semi-realistic. Once you've done that, just repeat on the other eye. Again, I'm going to go into time lapse and you can see how long it takes me. I am a perfectionist because it takes me ages, and if it's not right, it bugs me, and I cannot unsee the mistake. So I'm going to teach you how to do the mouth and nose, and then we can go on to the body as soon as I finished this eye. See you guys in a minute. So now I have zoomed in on the eye. It didn't take that long to get the eyelashes. I might do a second video in the future on how to draw different eyes, anime eyes, draw some cute eyes if any of you watch her. I used to watch her and then I made on to things like this. But if you guys are looking for something to start you off, then I would definitely start off with Draw So Cute or Christopher Hart. I started off with them and you can see the transformation. Like, this was a Draw So Cute Pikachu, and then you can see that I'm coming on to drawing things like this. So to start with the eyebrow, I just do a line to the base and then I go around like that and shade in. I don't want it to look too angry, but I don't want it to look too cheesy in a way, if that makes sense. But now I'm going to do the same on the other eye here, and I will see you in a minute. So now I've done the eyebrows and the eyes, I can edit them later. This is the nose, which I'm going to do now. It's probably the hardest bit, so definitely keep your eyes peeled and your ears awake. You're going to start off with the eyebrows, and you're just going to make a small gap between them and just mark them with a small diagonal line. Then go down to make the middle of the nose. You've got the hardest bit done because sometimes you don't want your character to look like a pig. And that's what usually happens. Sometimes the nostrils are too flared or the nose is too small. I've had quite a bit of practice on doing noses. Yeah. Then you kind of go out and kind of buff up the nose. As you come down, and then you kind of go in. Again, this is semi-realistic, so it's not going to be perfect, but it's not gonna be bad. And then you kind of go with two small dots to make the nostrils. I'm gonna definitely zoom in so you can see what I'm doing. So then you start off with two small nostrils like that, and then you go back around like that and then go back in. Then you create a shape with the nose a bit like that, and then you do two small lines. These are a bit faulty. There we go. So these just represent what's just above the mouth. The mouth is quite easy and I don't think you're going to need a tutorial on how to do that. But yeah, I'm going to draw the mouth, and that's quite easy. You can do just a normal smile or you can do pretty much anything. But these two lines here are important. I'm going to do this quickly, and then I'm also going to put it in flash place so you can see me draw the mouth. You get what I mean by the mouth, but I'll say the mouth is quite easy. Again, the hair is easy, it's just a lot of lines creating something spectacular. Since I have a gentle hat, I always like to do a fringe underneath the hat, which is super easy. You're just going in with mini lines like that. And this is where you can choose if you want it to be a man or a woman. You can leave it like this and have it as a man, or draw more hair and have it as a woman. It's completely up to you, or you can do a man with long hair. It's pretty much up to you. I'm going to do it as a girl, as you've already got double piercings in the ears and eyeliner and eyebrows, which makes it look a bit more feminine. So I'm going to go ahead and draw the hair. Okay, I've done the hair, now I'm going to do the body, and this is the easiest bit, believe me. Just a few lines, create the shoulders, and a bit of definition in the arms, and then you add on, you can design your jumper, or your shirt, or your dress. However you want. So, you can see that we've already done a bit of the t-shirt or jumper here. So I'm going to change positions again so you can see the best way to do this. Sorry, I just got a bit of a hiccup. So then I do lines to create the shoulders. You can make your character how skinny or chubby as you like. Especially if you're doing a self-portrait and you just use them as a guide. Then I'm sure it'll be great. So then you're going to draw lines down here, so that's from the shoulders down to the bottom of the sleeves. So you just go down like this and down like this. You can also make it however tall or small. So then you can maybe make the shoulders a bit more round. Or something else. You can really do whatever you want with it. That's why I like drawing, it can be your own. Then you're just going to create two V's. I know what you're thinking, why are you creating V's? From the V's you're going to go down, and now I think you'll get why I'm doing V's. This just makes the arms. And now you are pretty much done with the drawing. You can create legs if you want, but if you just want maybe a normal portrait, you can stop there. That is my video, and I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Comment down below if this has helped you with your drawings. I really hope it has. Love you guys. See you later. Bye.